Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel and welcome to the first PSVR 2 news video of July. Today we're gonna talk about Arizona Sunshine 2, also we're gonna talk about Pistol Whip and also a bit about Gran Turismo 7. Before I start, I'm planning on buying new microphone. Don't know what, give me some advice in the comments, feel free to tell me what new microphone for this channel going to be. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get started. I honestly have no clue what microphone to get my son. So we're gonna begin from Arizona Sunshine 2. So here we are on the developers, well, the game's Twitter, the OG Arizona Sunshine, that become Arizona Sunshine. No, it's not, no, what I'm talking about. This is Arizona Sunshine 2 Twitter, see me. Of course, you've got this trailer, but the developers shared some screenshots and concept art from the game. This is the first one looking great. The Fred is sporting a gas mask, like a true undead hipster. He poses an undying zest for unlife brains and fresh air. So yeah, now we don't know still what is the game and what is CG. I would assume this is probably, might be a bit of a CG, but maybe the assets are from the game. Or maybe it's done in aging. It's hard to tell, but by geometry I would think it's the game assets. But because you've got here blur and depth of field, I would feel like it's like CG. But still, looking great. You can pull bullet through somebody's head, so you know, that's all right. So that's one of zombies, I suppose. This game looks beautiful from the trailer. I like the details. I'm assuming that's one of guns you'll be handling. That's a sniper lifer. So is that sniper? Yeah. So close, wow, that's packed some punch, some blood splats, very nice. And great little details in the background. And then they shared, not this, this is just something. They shared a concept art here, which looking great. Feast your eyes on this gory juice concept art from Arizona Sunshine 2. Okay, maybe our choice of words needs work. Anyway, join the horde and wishlist. So this is one of the areas of the game, I'm assuming. So looks like you'll be able to enter the sewers. And this is, looks very nice and detailed. If this concept art gonna end up being the game, this bit here gives me really like Last of Us vibes, especially with those vines growing here, you know, everything is ruined. Looking pretty cool. So yeah, how much of this concept art gonna become a game, it's yet to see for us, but I must say so far it's looking really cool. And of course the trailers, I mean you can see bits here, the trailer make it look great. This is a bit as well, that's CG as well, one of zombies, of course shot by you. The desert looks great, everything looks awesome. Okay, now moving on to the next story, I want to talk a bit about another cool VR title in general, not only PSVR 2. And this is Pistol Whip. New scene, good news out now, basically. We think you're gonna fall for this all new scene. Good news, the third of five new scenes for the Overdrive season is available now. Learn more here, blah, blah, blah. So this is the trailer. I'm just gonna put it from straight from the Twitter. So of course, quality will be a bit like blurry, but whatever. Twitter compression is basically massive sometimes. So this is one of new scenes. Okay, so people falling everywhere. This game is so cool. You know, it's come out kind of with PSVR1 lifespan, and it worked great on PSVR1. Of course, tracking on PSVR1 it was like bit. But with PSVR2 tracking and HDR and beautiful colors, this looking great. So this is your brand new scene called Good News to your Overdrive season. It's out now, as you can see, on every platform. So yeah, Pistol Whip going strong. The Cloudhead Games definitely got themselves kind of a hit game. Okay, I want to talk a bit about Gran Turismo now. We are here on the GT Planet website. So basically what they got a bit of an exclusive interview with Dr. Peter Wurman, I don't know how to say it. And basically he's from the Sony's AI. And he's talking about Sophie. I'm not gonna read all of it, but basically there's some interesting questions being asked, and of course this is something what's gonna come back to GT7 and something what we'll be able to play against as well, especially if you like me and don't like play online. GT7, I can tolerate it playing online against other people, you know, there's no that team play involved. But I hate when people using me as their brake. You get in front of somebody and, you know, they just knocking you off the track. Anyway, this is what they got to say. What were some of the more interesting data points that you collected with Sophie debut in GT7? Releasing Gran Turismo Sophie in GT7 allowed us for the first time to evaluate how well the neural network performed embodied in the game. We learned quite a bit about specific engineering tasks involved in making the agent fully integrated, as well as the game design itself. GT Sophie is such a good driver that it was challenging to find combinations of cars that made the races fun for a variety of skins. Yeah, you won't think how much it's coming how much it takes to make the AI working like that. You just think it's just gonna work, but it's not. It's a lot of work. What are your thoughts of the various reactions of the public to Sophie? What do you think the general consensus was from players? Did any comments or opinions surprise you? We saw a lot of very positive comments by players about GT Sophie. They voiced strong support for rolling out the technology throughout the campaign mode, and that's something I would love, you know. That would be great. Many said that it provided a game-changing racing experience and that racing GT Sophie resembled the best experience they had racing other humans in the online mode, but without the hassles, that's what I say. Many also requested the ability to turn down or modulate the skill so that they could find a level that matches their playing skill. What do you believe are the biggest misconceptions that users have about Sophie or how it works? A lot of players understood the technology quite well, but there were also quite few misconceptions. For one, theories were shared about how easy it should be to make a slower version of GT Sophie. We've been working on that, and it turns out to be a lot harder than it may initially seem to make an agent that is slower in real human way, which shows the AI is really hard to control. It was also interesting how, I don't mean it like in a sinister way, by the way, I just mean like it's really hard for them to pull off. It was also interesting how much the players anthropomorphize the agent, attributing intentions or desires to the agent's behavior when it was really just reacting to the situation at hand. Of course, our goal is to create an experience that mimics racing against good, clean human drivers, so in a sense, having players describe the agents in human terms was a testament to how well it worked. Have you made any changes to the direction Sophie Research since the first public test as a result of the public's reactions to or experiences? We've been looking at some of the anomalous behavior that were reported to see if we can improve the training. We also been working on PDI to make a version of the agents that can drive many more cars and be used in more flexible gameplay scenarios to give players more control over races. The progress of AI research in general has rapidly accelerated over the past year. How have those changes impacted Sophie's development? Are you using any new techniques? The Gran Turismo Sophie Race Together mode was one of the first time a system trained through reinforcement learning has been delivered into a production environment. If you think about it, it was, and it's strange to think about it like that, but yes, it's true. This demonstrates that this technology can provide robust solutions to complex domains. The rapid advances in generative AIs are certainly something we watch closely, but we haven't changed our approach. After all, you can ask ChatGPT how to drive a race car fast, and it will give you reasonable advice like hit the apex of the corners, but ChatGPT can't actually control the car, give you specific instructions for specific racing scenarios, or tell whether a racing incident deserves penalty, and here they asking about PS4 version of that, and it probably won't happen. So GT Sophie, something I'm looking forward to returning, just so I can play offline without, but feeling realistic. Right, okay, if you're buying yourself VR prescription lenses, if you go to vrrock.com, down there you can buy them. And then if you use code PAULVR in vrrock.com, then you get yourself a nice 10% off from your order. It works with everything, not just PSVR2 lenses, but when in this video you see PSVR2 lenses being attached. The link to that is also in the description, so go and check it out. And big, big shout out to all the patrons scrolling down there at the bottom. You are all awesome and I super appreciate your support. And for now, for today, that's it. I see you all later. Bye, 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 bye.